And I do have a cat sleeping on my bed at the moment.
Gina,
so I'm trying not to be too loud.
Walker Chow.
But it's a cat, so he can sleep through anything. When both minions fight each other, they both take damage. So yeah, if you hit a minion into another minion,
it is good to
they both
see
take damage.
Lore Walker Cho.
Show me what you've learned.
Show me
I
what
you
learned.
I will not hold back.
Good, good.
Alright, so I'll play my one cost Murloc Raider, which has two attack and one health, and end my turn because that's all I can do. And I have a Bloodfen Raptor for next turn, which has three attack and two health, and a Raid Leader for turn three.
Many friends. Yes, Lord Walker.
Pandaren Scout, that's fine. So what do I want to do? Do I want to play a spell that can kill hit, that I can kill this? Or do I want to just hit my Murloc into his? Now, ordinarily, you'd want to save something like this that says to all enemy minions for when there's more than one minion on the board. So I think I'm going to save this and wait until he puts some more things on the... plays more minions. That way I can do more damage to more things. That's being efficient. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play my dinosaur, my raptor, and just hit him in the face because he'll probably use his
Even
scout to hit my raider.
Damage can mean the difference between victory and defeat.
Yeah, I'm not listening to you, actually. And so he just used his to attack mine. That's a trade up for him. And also down here on the side, you can see a history of what's been played. So I played this my first turn. He played that his first turn. I played mine, hit him in the face. And then he put his 1-1 minion, 1-1 meaning attack and health, into my 2-1, meaning its attack and health. So that was a trade up for him. That was a more valuable move for him because mine was a more powerful minion than his. So do I want to do this? It's really the best choice I have, so I'll just do that and hit him in the face. Again. And he's going to do that. Knock his Pandaren Monk into my Raid Leader. And what my Raid Leader had done was its ability, give your other minions plus one attack. That's only while it's on the board. So this my Raptor had hit him for four, but once the Raid Leader was off the board, now it's back to being a 3-2 instead of a 4-2. So there's a lot of different things to keep track of, like minions' abilities and when they actually take effect and when they don't. So I think I will do this, just keep hitting him. Whack. So what he can do next, I'll actually take a moment to talk about this before I end the turn. What he could do is put his River Crocolisk here into my Raid Leader, and the Crocolisk would still survive because that's a 2-3. It has 2 attack and 3 health, while the Raid Leader only has 2 attack and 2 health. So it'll do 2 damage to... They'll do 2 damage to each other, but this will stay on the board with 1 health. To end the turn. That could be what he does, but that may not be what he does. I don't know yet. Legacy of the Emperor. Oh, that's not something I remember being in the tutorial the first time I played this. That's bad. So what he just did was cast a spell that permanently gave his minions more health, more stats. So they are now stronger than they were the first time, so I think I am going to play this.
Oh, a clever play!
Just to do a little bit more damage to those, get those off the board, play my Crocolisk and my Murloc. That turn used up all of my mana. And I will just hit his Crocolisk with my Raptor. And then
my respects, Elder.
We'll see what he does. He plays another Monk, that's fine. Transcendence.
You cannot reach me!
For now. After I destroy your troops, I'm coming for you.
See, this is a spell that's only in the tutorial, unless they put Pandarens in later on. I don't know yet. What this spell does means I have to do something until I can attack his face, so I have to clear his board to be able to do that. A Magma Rager is not a powerful minion. See, this has 5 attack, and which does a lot of damage, but it only has 1 health. So it's not entirely worth it to play it. Do that. Do that. I guess I'll just leave it alone. See, because if I played it,
I have made some new friends who can heal as well as fight.
Like, what?
Someone call for
dinner. Oh, come on. Battlecry is something special that... Yeah. So Battlecry minions do something special when you play them. This one had the ability, Battlecry of Restore 2 Health. So that's a targeted ability. When it says Restore 2 Health, when you play it onto the field, you can restore 2 health to a minion or to your hero or to whatever you want. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play my minion, which has a Battlecry of Draw Card. Ooh. And then this minion has a very nice one. This has a battle cry of deal 3 damage to the enemy hero. So I can do that, but I think I'll just do this instead. Force him to do something about it. There we go. He has one of his own. That's fine.
Hate leads to an upset.
It's a little annoying, but it's fine. It's doable. Ah, okay.
War should be a last resort.
Hush your face. So I can do this. Play my minion, which has 2 attack and 7 health, so it means it can stay on the field for a long time.
Oh, if you're sure.
Put my 1-1 minion, which is 5-1 minion, and as I had said before, that's a trade up for me, because while my minion only had 1 attack and 1 health, his had 5 attack and 1 health. So it's me making more efficient trades. I'm doing something that makes my game easier. Now, can I attack him with this? No, I can't. And I really don't want to do this. But, see, I don't want to play my fireball to clear off his Voodoo Doctor, but I kind of have to in order to be able to continue attacking my enemy. So there's going to be times when you do make unfavorable trades. So that's fine. He just restored 2 health again. And I'm going to play Arcane Intellect to draw myself 2 more cards. Which gives me this big stonking guy. I love this guy. He has 6 attack, 7 health, very difficult to get rid of, can stay on the field for a long time, and I will just bop him and play my Nightblade. This game is actually going on much longer than it usually does, because I just haven't been playing as effectively as I could, but that's fine. Not a big deal. Oh, here we go, lovely. So since I have 10 mana, I can do this. I can play my Nightblade, which has the battle cry, deal 3 damage to the enemy hero. Attack him for 6 with those 2 minions, and then hit him in the face for 6 more. And I win again. And he just dissolves. Yay! And that gets me another card, Wolf Rider, which has Charge, which will be explained in the next match, I assume. But Charge is an ability that means when it enters the field, it can attack right away. It doesn't have to wait a turn to be used in battle. And we're going up against King Mukla.
Jaina versus King Mukla.
I don't recognize or know any of these. I don't play World of Warcraft. I'm considered it, but I also play DC Universe Online, and that's the only MMO I need. I don't want to sink my time into too many different things. I already lose enough to this as well. Don't understand a card, mouse over it. So as I've been doing, if you don't understand what a card does, you just put your mouse over it. This coin toss will be explained in a different tutorial as well. So if you don't understand a card, you just put your mouse over it, and it tells you what it does. So charge means it can attack immediately.
King Mukla. Get him while he's alone.
Heyo. Play my 1 mana costing card and wait for his turn. Throw 2 bananas.
Why are these monkeys throwing bananas at me?
I have a banana now, which means I can buff up a minion if I want to. Buff up meaning give it just more stats, give it a stronger attack and another health. So if I want to do this, I could play my Stone Dusk Boar, which has the ability to charge, meaning I can attack with it as soon as I play it. Give him a banana, meaning it's now a 2-2 instead of a 1-1. As you can see there on the underneath the title there, it says bananas. This minion has +1/+1. So instead of being a 1-1, it's now a 2-2, and I can just knock his monkey in the face. That's a sentence I didn't think I'd say this morning. And then hit him in the face with my Murloc. There we go. And this one also has bananas. Hey. Yes, we get it. You're a monkey man. Cause he's a monkey.
Is that all you've got, Mukla? Just barrels?
I don't think so. I don't like that laugh. So what I'm going to do is I could play my Wolf Rider and use that to attack into this crazy monkey, but since it only has one health, it would die immediately. However,
ready to ride.
I can play my Murloc into that. That's fine. And then just use these two to attack him in the face. Boom, boom, boom. This is going to be a long video. I'll end it after this one, and then I'll, after this match, and then I'll put the other... Ow! Not cool. And then I'll put the other tutorial matches in another video after this. So, I think I will do River Crocolis, just to get something on the field. I can't attack with it because it doesn't have charge like this one does. And I will play my Voodoo Doctor, which has the Battle Cry of Restore 2 health. If I had another minion that was slightly damaged, I could, damaged, I could heal it if I wanted to, but I will instead heal myself. And also, since I have a mana left, I will put that onto my Voodoo Doctor to make it a little bit stronger, and end my turn. So he's gonna do that, okay. Ah! Okay. See, this gorilla has taunt,
so I can finish off Mukla.
Which means I have to attack it. I have to get rid of this minion before I can attack my enemy hero. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play my Raid Leader, which gives my other minions plus one attack. And then hit his gorilla with my Voodoo Doctor. Since it now has four attack, it still survives because it had two health. And it gets a little complicated. There's a lot of actions to keep track of. But it's a game I quite like because of that. And another stomp. So he just got rid of everything on my side of the board. So yay. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to play a fireball into that. I don't like doing because it's 6 damage into something that only has 4 health. I don't like that, but oh well. Play an Ops Engineer, which has the Battle Cry draw myself a card, which gives me a taunt minion. And this, since this guy has 3 attack and 5 health, he's very durable.
Do you hear something?
Oh yes, I hear that. Mukla's big brother.
What the?
Big stompy, just
ruined that giant gorilla.
So what I can do is I can play this minion, which has taunt, which means this guy will have to hit into this. This card is not actually in this game. This would just be absolutely ridiculous to actually have in a game. It's absurd. 10 attack and 10 health for 6 mana is absolutely unreasonable. So what instead I'm gonna do is that. Just have this up as a little bit of a shield wall. So he has to hit that. Deal 2 damage to my face because he's a jerk. And then I will do this. Play some more taunt. Draw 2 more cards. And I will do this. I don't want to do it because it only affects one minion, even though it says it affects all. There's only one minion on the board. So I will play this, have it on the board, do that, and that buys me a little bit more time. It's going to do 2 damage to my face again because it's a jerk, but since I have 6-7 damage on the board, I can play that again, hit him in the face, and then he's dead next turn. That to my face again, that's fine, doesn't matter, because he can't hit me, and I can do this, and I win.
Sure.
Oh, don't be so overly dramatic. Yay! Ah, another spell. This is why I hate playing against mage class. There's other classes in the game, which I'll explain once the tutorials are over, but this spell right here is just the bane of my existence.
I don't think that's the last we'll see of Mukla.
And who's next? Hemet Nessingwary.
Hemet Nessingwary!